What do you know about the Irish Troubles?
I know that the Protestants were fighting the Catholics, and I haven't heard about it in a while, so it must not still be going on.
The Irish Troubles that I remember when I was your age was the Catholic and the Protestants not getting along in Ireland, and as a result, I would hear stories on the news about killings or bombings and things like that, and it was always religious and related, and they just couldn't seem to get along. And in comparison to today's world, when you have people flying planes into buildings and suicide bombers and people detonating bombs, what happened back then seems to be minor in comparison to what happens today. It just seemed like it happened a lot more frequently. That's the problem. That's what I remember. But I don't seem to hear as much about that now as I did like back in the 70s and late 60s and 70s and maybe early 80s. It seemed to happen a lot.
He's a professor at University of Missouri, St. Louis, and he's the head of the Irish Studies department there. And he's a very well-respected professor, not only here in St. Louis, but pretty much worldwide. And we really appreciate him meeting with us. We know he has a busy schedule and he's been traveling a lot lately. And just taking the time out of the day after class to meet with us. He seemed like a nice guy on the phone, so we can't wait to talk to him. And it'll be really cool because he actually grew up in Ireland, in Dublin, during the times of the Troubles in the 1970s. So thanks in advance, Dr. Wall.
Just a little bit of preface. Our project was on the Troubles.
Okay.
Because we're doing a social justice project.
Okay.
For our global history class.
Okay.
So we chose the Troubles.
Okay, good.
Which, you being from Ireland and
yeah,
a professor,
yeah, yeah,
know more about than us.
Yeah,
probably.
Maybe, hopefully. You never know.
So my first question is, do you know anyone who was involved with either the IRA or the Ulster forces?
I can't answer that question because if somebody is involved in the IRA, it's illegal. So nobody in Ireland in the north of the south can say I was involved with, say, the IRA, because it's an illegal organization. So nobody I knew ever told me that they were involved in the IRA. You know, so I mean, I'm sure I met people who were, but they never told me. You know, and you know, so it's. But where I lived in the south, was very, in some ways, it's a long way away from the troubles. There was very little of the troubles, you know, where I lived in Dublin and in the southeast. But at the same time, it was part of life.
So, along those lines, I know there's a lot of different opinions on who's responsible. Do you have any opinion on who's responsible, or just it's everybody's fault and it's nobody's fault?
Well, I think it's very complicated, you know, and I think that nowadays, because of the peace process, because of a reconciliation and all those kinds of things, we want to get away from asking those kind of questions, who's to blame, instead of how is the things rebuilt, I think. Some people have very black and white ideas of what happened, who was at fault, who's to blame, etc. I don't think that that way of thinking is very useful. For peace, because of peace, you know, with economic kind of development in the north. So if you started getting into this other stuff, like talking about United Ireland, would that destabilize things and make it more difficult for things to change, you know?
Sick of sorrow, sick of the pain, sick of hearing again and again that there's gonna be.
Our guest is Betty Williams, who was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize for her work against violence in her native Northern Ireland. In 1997, she founded a non-profit organization called World Centers of Compassion for Children. So Betty, could you please tell us or lead us up to how, or the events that led up to you winning the Nobel Peace Prize?
The work began because I witnessed the death of three children on the Belfast street, and I can't sort of put into a very short interview the amount of work it took to get Northern Ireland where it is today, but I can synopsize for you. In Northern Ireland we had probably every scenario that you could think about that causes violence. First was we had very, very bad working conditions. We had 14.5% unemployment problem of 1.5 million people. We had socialized violence of the worst kind, laws that were unjust, and we had a Protestant government for a Protestant people. And if you let those things go on in a country long enough, you know, people are going to get very angry about what's going on. And we also had the terrible bigotries of anti-Catholicism, all the stuff that you see going on in many other countries when religious groups decide that their God's different to somebody else's, you know? And so we had violence erupt in the year 1963, and it went on and on and on, and we were in a sickening cycle of useless violence that was going nowhere. And I'd seen a lot of things happen, a lot of two of my own family were killed in the war, and then one day I was out doing my shopping and I called into my mother's to have a cup of tea. Because if my mother heard you passed her door and hadn't come in for a cup of tea, you were in big trouble, you know. And as I was driving home, I heard shots ring out. I heard the shots of an Armalite and then the return fire of a self-loading rifle. The Armalite being the weapon of the IRA, the self-loading rifle, the weapon of the British Army. And found out that the IRA had opened fire on a British Army foot patrol. The foot patrol returned fire, killing the driver of the car. The car mounted the pavement into three children and their mother. And that was the scene that I witnessed. It was carnage beyond belief. And every time things like that used to happen in Northern Ireland, we would get statements coming out from various politicians and the terrorist organisations saying, like, in the case of the IRA, they would say, oops, sorry, we didn't mean to do that, you know. And I think all of Northern Ireland, particularly the women, were absolutely sick of that. And so after I witnessed the death of the babies, I went door knocking. And I wasn't a very nice person on the doorstep. I was very angry. And I asked women that if they felt like I did, that would they join me in a rally, the spot where children were killed. I thought maybe about 100 people would turn up if I was lucky. But 10,000 women came to the first rally, and then we had a series of 12 rallies all over Northern Ireland and Great Britain. And then after the rallies, we sat down and made a plan of how we would economically, socially and culturally begin to change what was wrong in Northern Ireland. And that's what we did. We started off with creating small industries, schools, bringing our children together, all that kind of thing. And that's, I think that's why they looked at it as being a thing that perhaps a Nobel Prize would. I can never understand why I got it, to be honest.
In particular, do not affect SLU or St. Louis in a noticeable way. The larger issues here, such as terrorism and sectarian conflict, do. It seems wherever you go, you can see signs of how terror has gripped our society. The airwaves are filled with talking heads arguing on how to approach this issue, and our hate for foreigners, particularly Muslims, seems to grow each day.
Trauma overseas, yeah, we trying to stop terrorism, but we still got terrorists here living in the USA, the big CIA, the Bloods and the Crips and the KKK. But if you only have love for your own race, then you only leave space to discriminate, and to discriminate only generates hate, and when you hate, then you're bound to get irate. Yeah, madness is what you demonstrate, and that's exactly how anger works and operates. Man, you gotta have love just to set it straight. Take control of your mind and meditate. Let your soul gravitate to the love, y'all.
People killing, people dying, children hurt and you hear them crying. Can you practice what you preach, and won't you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us, send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning.
Change. New days are strange. Is the world insane? If love and peace are so strong, why are the pieces of love that don't belong? Nations dropping bombs, chemical gases filling lungs of little ones with ongoing suffering. As the youth are young, so ask yourself, is the loving really gone? So I could ask myself, really, what is going wrong in this world that we living in? People keep on giving in, making wrong decisions, only visions of them dividends. Not respecting each other, denying thy brother. A war's going on, but the reason's undercover. The truth is kept secret, it's swept under the rug. If you never know truth, then you never know love. Where's the love, y'all? Come on.
I don't know.
Where's the truth, y'all? Come on.
I don't know.
Where's the love, y'all?
People killing, people dying, children hurt and you hear them crying. Practice what you preach, and would you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us, send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning. Where is the love?
Where is the love? Where is the love? Where is the love?